Hi, my name is Simon Howard, and I'm a solution architect at Micro Focus. This video is all about how you use Fortify SCA within an IDE. So when developers change code, they typically go through a process a bit like this. A new feature or bug results in a ticket. Someone within the team scopes the changes, perhaps looking at the ticket from the backlog. Then the developer that's assigned the issue within, say, a sprint, goes through an iterative implementation of those code changes. They make changes to the code, they build it, they debug and test it, and within that IDE environment, they might also perform static analysis of the code as well, both from a quality and security point of view. And then when they've done that several times and all the changes are complete and they work, then they'll commit the changes and the ticket is updated. And that's the process. So how can you use Fortify within an IDE? So you can initiate scans, as we saw or hinted at early in the previous slide. The scans are performed within the IDE environment. You can define settings for that scan, you can configure them, but it's a manual process, of course. Then when the scan is complete, you can view the results. The issues will be grouped into critical, high, medium, and low buckets. You can group those issues in different ways, depending on what your needs are, what you're interested in. For each of those issues, you can view the details, and you can get remediation guidance. And that's ideal for a developer. And in some of the IDEs, you can also generate reports as well. For each issue, you can add audit comments to the history. You can raise bug tickets in some of the supported IDEs, so in your supported bug tracker. You can upload the results to SSC, so the whole team can look at the results of a scan perhaps you did locally. But also, you can audit SSC-based results in the IDE. That might be a scan that was maybe initiated from a CI pipeline. Also, there's an additional bit of functionality you can use in Visual Studio and Eclipse called Fortify Security Assistant. And that's a plugin that finds a subset of issues as you'd write your code. So let's go and look at some of these plugins in action. Okay, so what you see in front of you is IntelliJ, and you see a Java project, which has obviously Java code, JavaScript code and HTML code. And I'm going to go and scan that. So I already have the plugin installed. So I have a menu item called Fortify. And to do that, I'm going to do an advanced scan. Wizard starts. I'm going to leave everything as is. This is where the output file is going to go, the results, an FPR file. This little part shows me all the things that's automatically worked out for me, the things it's going to scan. I'm going to click finish, and now my scan is starting. The output in this particular IDE is shown down here. It's building intermediate files. It's going to do the analysis, and then the results will be available. And now the scan has completed, as you can see here in this little window here, and it's given me the opportunity to upload the results to Software Security Center, which I'm going to do. So I'm just going to get my password. Copy it in, and now the results are going to be uploaded to a project in SSC. I'm going to select this one here. This is the application. This is the revisional version, and now it's uploaded into SSC. You can see it's submitted as a background activity. Now I can open the results within the IDE. So I'm going to enter my credentials again. Select the same place where I put the results here. Open it up. Now there are my results now that have come directly out of SSC. Let's make this window slightly bigger. My results are categorized into the four buckets, critical, high, medium, and low. I'm going to select critical, and I'm going to look at one of the vulnerabilities. So I select SQL injection. I'm going to look at this one here. And you can see here's some details of the vulnerability. I've got recommendations and details tabs available to me. If I select details, that'll show me information about this vulnerability. I can read through that, gives me guidance of how, in this case, a SQL injection typically occurs in Java. I've got the recommendations tab that shows me what I could typically do in order to fix this type of vulnerability. And then I have an audit tab that shows me for each vulnerability, the event stack that leads up to the vulnerability, that's this here. These are links, so I can select on that, it'll take me directly to various places in my code. Go back, as you can see, I'm going back to the code here now. And the workflow would be, I work backwards to the point where the vulnerability starts, and the work, and then as part of that triage process, work out, is this a genuine vulnerability or not? In this case, it is. If I want to, within this IDE plugin, I can add comments. So I'm going to sort of select myself here, and I'm going to add a comment just to say something like this looks like an issue. That's added to the audit history, and that will directly now go into the audit history for this vulnerability in SSC, so the whole team can see that. Let's go look at the experience in a different IDE. So this is Visual Studio, and this is a .NET project, an ASP.NET project with a mixture of C# and ASP code. You can see the visual experience is slightly different. Here we have the information about the results displayed on the right-hand side, and the event stack feed vulnerability is shown here. So I've got a vulnerability already selected. Like in the IntelliJ view, I've got a set of tabs available to me. I've got the details tab that's showing me details of this particular SQL injection, this particular case. I have a recommendations tab again to show me recommendations how to fix this vulnerability, in this case, a vulnerability in C# code. I also additionally have a diagram view to show me how the code flows up to the point when the vulnerability occurs. And I also have a filters view. And like before, I have an audit view where I can basically add audit comments. And you can see here some have already been done for this vulnerability. Additionally, I can suppress an issue within the Visual Studio plugin. And I can also file a bug with a bug tracker. Now, additionally, I mentioned in the earlier slide, there is a plugin called Fortify Security Assistant, and this is designed for Eclipse and for Visual Studio. So here, as I said, we're in Visual Studio. Here is the Fortify Security Assistant menu item. Fortify Security Assistant enables you to do two things, actually. You can have a real-time analysis performed of your code as you're writing it. But also, it can also scan to look for some vulnerabilities as well, quite quickly as well. So let's go do that. So I can analyze this solution to look for vulnerabilities. I do that by selecting Analyze Solution. It's very quickly going to scan this. Took just 2 seconds. I can go to the error list view. And here's some vulnerabilities it found in the code, very, very quickly, as you can see. So I just double click on that. That takes me to a configuration file, and it's saying there's something wrong here within this item here. I can select this here, view vulnerability details, and what it's saying in this particular case, there's a vulnerability with this item here. It's saying I really should set this thing, HTTP only cookies, to true. So I could do that, and in real time, it would see that I'd made that change. So let's go do that. So this is this one here. If I go here within this element and add that item here, I should probably just type it in. So I can set it to true. If I set it to true, this will go. Let's take another one. Do the same thing. And you can see that's gone as well. So there you go. That's how you use Fortify Security Assistant. That's the end of this video. I'll see you in the next one.